Hi guys, thanks for joining us today for another Academy episode. Today, it's all about brushes. So let's pick up the brush tool from the toolbar. If you're familiar with our tools, this slider will be no stranger. And in this case, it's used to set the stroke width. Let's start off with a thin stroke, see how that looks. Okay, let's make it wider. And now it looks like this. You can also change this setting in the Style tab. So if we start all over and set the stroke width to just about here, this is the resulting brush path. The best part about vector brush strokes is that they act exactly like any path in our app. So you can adjust nodes in just about any way you want. You can delete them or play with the handles to change the angle, or simply tap and drag them around. But of course, you can also change the node type directly in the Style tab, from single to mirrored, angular, and disconnected. And the shape will adjust accordingly, of course. You can choose your brush profile by hitting this drop-down menu here, which opens the brush selection pane. All of your custom brushes are at the top, while any of the preset ones are down below. So let's just select a couple brushes to see what that does to our path. Simply tap, and as you can see, our shape took a whole different look. Now let's grab a brush that would work super well with calligraphy, like this one. So you can easily achieve this type of effect as well. Next, let's go into the brush editor and see what we can play around with here. All these parameters give you infinite possibilities to create custom brushes. We're definitely excited to see what you guys come up with. So let's see these settings in action. I'm gonna quickly write hello and make it bigger. Let's smooth this out and go back to the editor. Up top, we have the shape setting, which is controlled by the roundness and the angle of the brush. This is not only a live preview, but also an editable section of the shape. So if I pull on these nodes here, you can notice the shape and the parameters below changing in real time. But let's zoom into our brushstroke to see exactly what's happening. First, I'm going to make this end a bit wider. If the roundness is at 100%, the end of the brush is going to appear rounded, while the opposite holds true. 0% means that the brush will be completely flat at the end. Now, let's look at the angle. This one is visually very striking in my case, as you can see the shape changing along with the angle. Zooming out to make sure you guys catch this. Next in line, it's the minimum width, which especially affects very thin areas of your brush, like the end of my hello. So if we lower this to a minimum, the line is barely visible. You can tell how thin it is in the contour preview as well. You'll notice that we have two previews available. The shape one up top is viewed on the Z-axis, so imagine cutting your brush path and looking at it straight on. While this is the contour preview, which shows you exactly how the brush path will take shape. So how the width is distributed alongside it from the very first node until the last. Let's focus on it for a minute. This window allows you to adjust the contour of your brush as you change any vector path. So let's say I want to add some bumps in the shape. I just tap once on the line to add a node, and then I can freely move it around. The selected node is marked as blue. If you tap it again, the delete function appears, which is another way that you can change your contour shape. But if you double tap, the same delete function takes place, so it's faster to do it this way. So then, add, drag, move around, and release. And repeat until you create the brush profile you need. I think I'm going to leave mine like that for now. Let's see how this path shows up in comparison with our hello. If I draw a straight horizontal path, it looks pretty much just like the preview. And if we adjust the roundness, here's what we end up with. This brand new profile is now visible across all previews, but most importantly, it's visible in my shape. Okay, let's reverse these changes and try to improve my original brush path here. The end is a bit too thin, so I'll correct that with the minimum width slider, which makes the path more visible. Now that I'm happy with my brand new custom brush, I can just save it by tapping on the Save button down here. And now I can see it at the top of the selection pane, where it should be. That should pretty much cover today's lesson. Stay tuned for a second episode dedicated to brushes. I'll see you guys then.